Good morning, it's Kenenigan. I expected this. Yeah, I told you the other day the worst thing they could have done is not kill Donald Trump the other day. Because what it does, it creates the Streisand effect. They were hoping that it was successful and we'd all be fucking, well, not us. Bad state actors would be doing it, but they wanted chaos. Because that's how pathetic this Democratic Party is. They cannot run on any principles of what they actually fucking done for humans in their party for the past 3.5 years. They have nothing to run on. That's positive. The only thing that they did have something to put forward was stealing money off U.S. taxpayers with their fucking student loan bullshit. And, you know, it's basically taking taxpayers' money and using it to buy votes. Which is the only fucking thing there. Well, now, this isn't surprising. There's a huge divide in the left now. And the divide is, who wants to be on the right side of history? I honestly, for all intents and purposes, I do think that some of them are realizing that they've been doing nothing but protecting pedophiles the whole time. That's especially true with people supporting Disney and Lucasfilm. I think they're finally waking the fuck up. We're seeing a lot of hostility coming out of the other side. Cenk Uygur, the piece of shit from the Young Turks. Well, something's going on with Cenk. And his female partner here, Anna. I don't know what's going on with Anna. She seems to be rebelling against the Young Turks. She is turning into a conservative. I just watched this clip with her on... Cenk Uygur was on the Piers Morgan show yesterday. I watched it. He was an asshole. He was yelling at Piers Morgan. Oh, you idiots believe that this was staged. Piers Morgan didn't say shit about the assassination being staged. Cenk Uygur came out here with this pissy attitude, his combative piece of shit attitude, started yelling on the Piers Morgan show. Oh, you conservatives, all you Trumps, you think this is fucking staged. And Piers is like, you do know that there's some fucking anomalies going on with the shooting, right? Like, you just can't fucking ignore them, Cenk. Oh, yeah, you believe, yeah, because Biden said get him in the crosshairs, and use fucking mogatards. Yeah, whatever. Well, Anna has changed her. Here's what I think is going on with Anna. In the comments, they're saying the more she turns conservative, the prettier she's getting. Well, that might be true. Look, I adore all women, even if they're liberals. I just think they have some issues going on in their head. Unfortunately, sadly for women, white liberals in colleges have been who they've been trying to brainwash. Who do you think's behind most of this DEI and diversity and equity bullshit? It's normally white liberal women. But how do you change a woman's mind? What's going on with Anna? I don't think it has to do with money. Because the Young Turks, I'm telling you a secret, they've been subsidized by the CIA for many years to push deep state talking points. Cenk, I think he's involved in some other nefarious shit. Read between the lines on that one. I don't think Anna is. What I think happened to Anna, I believe she's dating a man now who probably red-pilled her. And I'm going to say something some of you might find this offensive, but it is the truth. I also think Anna is probably dating someone who can sexually satisfy her. Because that's how you really get a woman to listen to you. What do you think all this psychopathic acting out of deep state liberal actors comes from? It's from psychological fucking issues they have as children. If they were abused themselves as children by the deep state, they're going to grow up to be abusers themselves. That's what you see going on in Hollywood with a lot of the people like Bill Maher and all them. Yeah. With their fucking red shoes. We know what that stands for. But we're seeing a divide. And this divide is real. Cenk, I expect to see Anna gone from the Young Turks within a few weeks. She is, you listen to this rant she just did? She's defending Trump. She's like, look, we just can't go on calling them all Nazis. Like, this is, And I think that some people in the news media are starting to realize it is their fault. They're the reason that this happened. You know what I'm talking about. Here we have CNN losing their shit because, look, the people who have been coming up saying that there is some fuckery going on with this are ex-Special Force snipers. They know what the fuck they're talking about. You don't even need to be a sniper or in the military to know that you shouldn't have 1 minute, 57 second gap before they saw the gunman. They stood down. They let it happen. It's so fucking obvious that anyone can see it. But the other side is freaking out now about, God forbid you blame this administration for it. Jay.
My eyebrows go up. What?
See, look,
what
listen,
do you say
listen to what she's saying.
You don't want to be the conspiracist. You don't want to be the person.
I'm telling you, because that's what, it's leaning to.
No, I know. And that's the issues that you walk.
I'm going to end the video with this. Look, if you could support my channel, I'd appreciate it. I'm going to tell you something nobody else is going to tell you. Because I actually do my fucking research. And I'm a student of history, and I despise communists. So I'm gonna fill you in on a little secret that most people don't know within the United States. I need cigarettes, so if you could donate to the channel, I'd appreciate it. I don't want to have to go all day without cigarettes again. Anything would help. I appreciate the people who did buy T-shirts within the past day. I'll see that money at the end of the month. No big deal. It's in the bank. I did sell a couple T-shirts. Comments. Yeah, someone asked me. Somebody wants to mail me something for my birthday. Yeah, my birthday's in 10 days. I'm a Leo. Just figure that one out. July 27th. It's the week of my birthday. Please, you know, I don't want to have to go do nicotine withdrawal all fucking week. Yeah, my address is the same. If you do need my address, just email me. I'm planning to send you something for your birthday. Yeah, my address is still the same. If you need it again, just email me. You are so cute when you talk about real women. Love your merchandise. Hey, look, I'll even get I don't think Anna's a bad-looking person. She's natural, I'll tell you that. She is a girl. She's not a transformer, I'll tell you. I could tell the difference between real boobs and fake boobs. Most can't. But I just think she was brainwashed and she's breaking the programming. Hey, I'll tell you what else might be happening with Anna. She might have started taking up smoking marijuana. Why? Because it breaks MKUltra mind control. You find anyone who is a real big pothead, none of them are supporting the deep state. That's a fact. You might know, yeah, you might see some liberal potheads out in California, but that's not all they're doing is weed. They're doing other shit. Don't let them, yeah, no. If you got someone who's all they're doing, like me, it's just like smoking, it breaks MKUltra mind control, period. I have books in the occult written by Gerald Gardner himself, the godfather of Wicca. He's a piece of shit. He subverted Wicca. But right in his books, it says during occult ritual, drug use and drinking wine is promoted, except for marijuana. Yeah, when you got black magicians telling you not to smoke marijuana because you can't do it during occult ritual, what the fuck is going on there? They hate marijuana. Aleister Crowley promoted the use of amphetamines and heroin in his teachings. Don't spark that joint up, though. Because, yeah, it breaks MKUltra mind control. Who'd have thought? So, what's going on with Anna? She got a boyfriend who's taking care of her finally. And once that happens with a woman, there's no going back. She's going to stay loyal to whoever is, you know what I'm saying. Sank ain't doing that for her. Two, she started smoking weed. She's had an epiphany. The MKUltra mind control is away from her now. Or she knows that he's a piece of shit. He's involved in young ones, and she doesn't want to be associated with that. We are seeing a major divide. And what did you expect was going to happen? The worst thing they could have done was not kill him, God forbid, because everyone is looking at this now, and it's not going good. they had to take Morning Joe of MSNBC and his bitch wife Mika, if you want to call them that. I think they're reverse, you know what I'm saying? They had to take them off the air because they cannot trust what's going to come out of their mouth from a legal standpoint. Isn't that pretty pathetic, MSNBC? Because you don't know what's going to come out of your host's mouth today. And it could be a legal... Yeah, CNN host loses it. The whole clip is like 8 minutes long. I'm going to watch the whole thing. I didn't want to play it all. So, yeah, we got some strange things going on. Anna from the Young Turks is rebelling. I don't think she's going to be on the show much longer. I also think this is why Cenk was so hostile with Piers Morgan the other day, because he's losing Anna as co-host. If she goes, nobody's going to watch that fucking piece of shit. They're only there for her. Just saying. And he's losing her. Good. I think there's going to be a lot of people who are going to have to admit that this liberal way of thinking, they've been wrong for the past couple years, mind-controlled, bullshitted, gaslighted, whatever. They're just going to have to come to truth with it. Then the final nail in the coffin is going to be when you see people like me were absolutely 100% right the whole time, and all this shit revolves around human trafficking, and that's what they're really trying to protect. And I just think some people are trying to be on the right side of history. Now a lot of them are getting very defensive. Yeah, there's just, like with any event, the deep state, all this shit comes out. All this stupid things that they fucked up during the event. Everything from Trump's Secret Service detail to, they expected it to be successful, then everyone wouldn't be nitpicking all these little details of what went on. They expected, you know, not that MAGA conservatives were going to be the ones out there rioting. It would have been paid deep state actors with MAGA shirts on out there rioting, which is what they wanted to happen. Why? Because these people can't win the election and they're fucking pathetic. So they have to resort to this kind of behavior, inciting violence, riots. You try to throw your, you tell us you're not a communist fucking government, yet you're trying to throw your political leader in jail, trying to fucking assassinate him. People have had it. They're not that stupid. And people like Anna are saying, you know what? Fuck the deep state. I'm done. I'm done with the Young Turks. I'm done with you, Cenk. I'm done with the deep state. So we're seeing this too, which is good. I wouldn't be surprised if in a few weeks you see her rocking a MAGA shirt. Then Cenk will really lose his shit. Anyway, any questions or comments, leave them below. I was being serious. I do need cigarettes, so if you could support the channel. All the links are in the description. Take care, and God bless.